Ryan. I'm glad you're still here.
Oh, hey, Pat. Why, what's up? Do I have to sweep again?
No. I want to talk to you more about the asphalt volumetric terms.
Oh, okay. Like the GMB and the GMM.
Exactly. In fact, those are the two I want to talk about today.
I read your mind.
All right, whatever. So density is the first thing we need to cover. Density really is just the mass of a material divided by its volume.
Well, yeah.
So now that we know what density is, we want to talk about specific gravity. So specific gravity of a material is just its density divided by the density of water.
So let's say the mass of an asphalt mixture over its volume divided by the mass of water over its volume?
Yep. It's quite a mouthful, isn't it? So really what we do in the lab is we go ahead and use water at 25 degrees Celsius, and that turns its density into 1.
Wow. Makes it a lot easier to calculate.
It sure does. So now that we've established what specific gravity is, let's talk about the bulk specific gravity.
This is the one with the water bath, right?
It is. I want to talk about that test another time. But the bulk specific gravity, we're going to take the mass of the asphalt aggregate and binder, and we're going to divide it by the aggregate, binder, and air.
Okay.
So in practice, we're going to take that compacted sample, we're going to take the dry mass and divide that by the saturated surface dry mass minus the mass underwater.
Sure helps to see the equations.
Agreed. So let's move on to the maximum specific gravity. For this, we're going to measure the asphalt mixture in a loose or uncompacted sample.
Wait, this is the Rice test, right?
It is. And again, I want to cover that test another time. But for the maximum specific gravity, we're going to take the mass of the asphalt binder and the aggregate and divide it by the volume of the aggregate and binder.
That's similar to the bulk.
It is, but with this one, there's no volume of air. So in practice, we're going to take the dry mass and divide that by the dry mass minus the mass underwater.
So that's just mass over volume, isn't it?
It is.
So now that we can calculate the GMM and the GMB, where do we go from here?
I'm glad you asked. They're both very important. We do a lot of things with them. But the first thing we're going to do is we're going to figure out the volume of air. And to do that, we're going to take the bulk specific gravity, divide it by the maximum specific gravity, subtract all of that from 1, multiply it 100 to turn it into a percentage.
So that's where we get the air voids of a sample.
It sure is.
It's quite a process, but we talk about air voids all the time, so I'm glad to better understand where it comes from.
Well, it is pretty important.
If I remember correctly, in the volumetric terms, we call the air voids the VA.
We do. Good job. So it sounds like you've got it. So here's a bunch of masses that I brought from the laboratory. Let's go ahead and figure out the GMM, GMB, and the air voids of all these samples.
Sounds good to me.